For the base, I'm using the Skin Veil Base Dark Cushion number 40 Light Purple. They also have the other color, which is number 60 Light Green. Light purple is supposed to give skin a lively and vibrant appearance. It's recommended for those with yellow undertone. As for the light green, it's for clean, even skin tone, especially good for correcting redness. The formula is really light and soft. When I first applied on my skin, it didn't absorb into my skin directly. It took a while for it to absorb into my skin. It also has a cooling sensation while also moisturizing my skin. You don't really have to apply it on the whole face, you can just apply it on the part that's yellowish, especially around the center of the face. Leave it for a while, wait until it totally absorbs and settles into the skin, then I'm going to use this Pore Control BB Cushion. The formula is creamy and feels matte. The coverage is very sheer, so if you want to achieve higher coverage, you can apply another layer. But I wouldn't recommend you to apply more than that, or it will look cakey or patchy. When I apply it on my face, I feel like it didn't directly absorb into my skin and just stayed on top of my skin. It feels matte, but it gives slightly a dewy effect look. I have an oily skin, I think this will be a better option to use in summer, and this is definitely not for dry skin type, it might be a little bit drying for normal skin type too. For the powder, I'm using the Water Supreme Finishing Pack, and because the powder is not translucent, using a little bit is enough to cover the shiny parts and pores. The puff is really soft and the amount of product that it takes is just right. Even applying it on the face with foundation, the foundation did not stick to the puff, which I believe allows the puff to last longer. Next, for contouring, I'm using this Ideal Blush Duo number 6 called Wood Blossom. I love the packaging, it looks simple and clean, overall it looks very beautiful and classy. The material that it's made of feels sturdy and high quality. It even comes with a magnetized lock, so it's gonna be really secure. As for the blush, the color is really soft and it's pigmented, but it's a little bit patchy, so you can only use a slightly stiffer brush to apply it. And slowly even it out while applying it a bit by a bit, so that it won't look uneven. Next, for the brows, I'm using the Eyebrow Cushion Color number 1 in 2-tone gray. Since I have dark colored hair, I'm only gonna use the one that's on the left. The formula is thicker than I expected. This is probably my favorite eyebrow tint so far. It's not too watery, it's easy to control, and the result looks really natural and not patchy. For the eyeshadow, I'm using Ideal Shadow Quad number 4 called Deep Crimson. I picked this set because I thought the combination colors are great and suitable for fall season. The colors are bright and very pigmented. The formula is similar to Ideal Blush Duo Powder, except it's more pigmented. When applying, I like to apply it thinly at first so that it's easier to blend. Although it's quite buildable and easy to blend, I suggest you to apply it a bit by a bit so that the overall eyeshadow will look even. Next, I'm going to use the brown color and apply it at the end of the eyes. Now, Next, take the shimmery gold color. For this step, you need to use a sponge brush so that the shimmer will stick on the eyelid better. The shimmer sticks really well. It looks really bright and sparkly. This is suitable for you guys who likes to rock sparkly eye makeup look. Then take the white cream shadow and apply it on the inner corner of the eyes. Next, for the eyeliner, I'm using the Creamy Crystal Black Eyeliner. It's also available in brown color. The texture is creamy but stable, so it glides easily and easy to control. The color is very thick and solid, it's really dark, and the reflection is not dull, and the finishing is sparkly. You can also add a pair of falsies to complete the eye makeup look. Then curl your lashes and falsies together, then apply the mascara. I'm using the Lash Freshener mascara, and I like how it doesn't have any smell, and it really catches a lot of small lashes as I use it on my top and bottom lashes. Also, it's waterproof and doesn't clump either. Since the eye makeup is quite thick, it's better to prevent using too much blush powder on the cheek. I'm using the Ideal Duo Blush No. 5 Ginger Berry. Mix two of the colors together and lightly brush it on the apple of the cheeks in circular motion. For the lips, I'm using the two-tone matte lip bar number 1 called Burgundy Mood. This is one of the most popular items from their brand. I kind of understand why this product is so popular, although the shape is square and it makes it a little bit difficult during application, but it blends quite well. The texture is creamy but it's also quite matte. It's not sticky and it stays on the lips really well and it's not drying at all. Overall, my opinion about Laneige product is that their design is simple, but it's practical and of high quality. The effect of the products really pay off, and what I like the most is that the products smell really good. So if you like products that are designed simple, classy, and high quality, you definitely have to check out the products. So that's all for today. I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial, and I'll see you guys again on my next video.